decades since Monarch has won the 4A title. It's been more than 5 decades since Denver South has won a title. Who's going to win next? Coyotes, Rebels, 4A championship kickoff is next. I had my whole Tony Lindsay thing the other day. I'm like, he was born the last time, coincidence, CFL, Grey Cup. I liked it. And then I said,
Pueblo South.
And everyone was like,
huh?
Championship Saturday is a culmination of passion and hard work, a desire and dedication to be great, a season built on brotherhood, and a faith that dreams come true. It's one final game, and a day these young men will remember forever, and a chance to be crowned a champion.
And that journey continues at Sports Authority Field at Mile High. A glorious day in downtown Denver. 60 degrees, some clouds, some sun. And we go down to the field now and check in with the third member of our broadcast team, Tori Holt. Tori.
Mark, what an excellent day for football today down here at Sports Authority Field. The crowd is amped up both of these sides. I'm telling you what, I didn't realize sound had feel to it, and it does down here on the field here at Mile High. Well, I got an opportunity to talk to both coaches before the game today. The keys to a championship. Talk to Phil Bravo of Monarch. They want to hold on to that football like they did last week. Long time-consuming drives and no big plays. For Denver South, the Tony Lindsay, the charismatic one, said, hey, we got to score when we get the ball. Get some stops as well. They can't allow Monarch to hold on to that ball for 10 minutes. A drive should be a great game, boys.
We are looking forward to it, Tori. Two teams that are 12-1. There's Tony Lindsay. He was born 54 years ago, the last time Denver South won a title. It was a Triple-A title back in 1958.
Can't say enough about Coach Tony Lindsay, Coach of the Year in the state of Colorado. Great leader for the Denver South Rebels. His kids really, really buy into what he's selling. It's working, that's for sure.
Jamie Falloon will kick it off for Monarch. Denver South will be on offense to start the game, as we are ready for the 4A championship to get underway. Monarch's been here, done that 10 years ago, trying to win the second title in Coyotes history. And this one bounces at the 10 and returned to the left side, and a nice tackle at the ankles, and the Rebels will start at about the 18. There's the QB for the Rebels, Malik Tollerson, a dual threat at all times, Matt.
Dual threat in every sense of the word. He does a great job of running this offense, doing exactly what Coach Tony Lindsay wants him to do week in and week out. if you start walking up your safeties here, if you're the Coyotes, be aware that Mosley, the speedy wide receiver for South, is going to try and hit you over the top. Do not be shocked to see a lot of play action in this ballgame from South.
You just saw Pete Williams with Zach Lindsay in front of him. Williams, first carry right side, over the 20, still on his feet, and over the 30. He's got the 40 and steps out of bounds at the 42, a big run for the Rebels.
And they started off very similar to the way they finished it last week, giving the ball to Super Pete, number 28. They do a great job of running right, sealing down. Great block at the point of attack by Lindsay, 25. And once Pete Williams gets the corner, it's over, folks. You better take a great angle on this kid because he can outrun him.
How about a gain of 24 yards on your first play from scrimmage?
Right off the bat, that's the way to set the tone early. Exactly what you can expect from South the majority of the afternoon.
Now from the 42. As we look at today's starting lineups, brought to you by your local Ford stores. Thrown out to the left side, Kerryon Chambers with another first down gain as he gets it up to about the 40 of Monarch.
I love the changeup. They're going to play off coverage. The Coyotes secondary is playing off coverage on Chambers. He's got a 10-yard bubble right there. Stand up, deliver the football, let the athlete pick up some yards in space, move the chains again, two first downs on two plays.
Make it the 45, not the 40. As the Rebels are on the move. Same formation. Tollerson the give. And Williams is hit at the line. No gain.
Colin Hart, number 24, the leader for that Monarch defense. Guy is a spark plug in the middle and does a great job of getting everybody lined up. Sal tries to pull the whole backside offensive line on the counter. They do a good job of reading it. 24, right in there, making a nice play.
He's the guy that gets the defensive calls and signals it to the Coyotes' D. And no gain on that last run by Williams, second and 10.
Way to calm down by the Coyote defense.
Two receivers to the right for Tollerson and the Rebels. They'll roll that way and look, holds, now steps up, out of the pocket. Room to run on the left side. Over the 30. And another first down for Denver South. Steps out at about the 27. Let's take a look at today's players to watch, brought to you by your local Ford stores. And this is when the Rebels are on offense. Boy, they are off to a quick start here at Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Zach Lindsay, in that game against Wheat Ridge, was all over the field, both sides of the ball.
And he does it all. The junior is great out of the backfield. He's great on defense. It's really a guy you need to keep your eyes on. Number 25 is a beast out there for the Rebels. Hart and Hurst, the two Monarch defenders that were just pictured, those are the unquestioned leaders for the Coyotes. They really need to step up, win personal battles. In games like this, you need to win one-on-one matchups. When Hart is one-on-one, he needs to win and make tackles. When Hurst is one-on-one, he needs to win and put pressure on the quarterback and make tackles in the backfield. That's the way that they're going to get South off the field. You don't want to let them just chip away, chip away, chip away. Then they're going to go big time over your head with play action.
Great day here in downtown Denver as we watch the fans. Now second and 6. Tollerson, the pitch. And Williams picks his way around the left side. And near the marker, it'll be just short. Third and short coming up. I got it. There's Pete Williams, 5'8", 178, the senior. Head coach Tony Lindsay. He kind of describes guys with one word, and he said jackrabbit. That's what he calls Pete Williams.
I see that. No doubt about it. Pete Williams is small in stature, yet he will run you over. So he's not afraid of contact, even though he is considered more of a speed back.
Third and one of the big man's in. And that's Trevante Tasco. And look at Tank. That's your guy all the way down to the 2.
That's right. And they line up Tank Tasco in the I formation at the running back position. Usually he's playing fullback. Feed the big man the rock. The wheels on the bus go round and round for Tank Tasco. Watch the explosion through the hole here. Great down block. Great lead by number 25, Lindsay. And then I don't even know where you're supposed to hit this guy. Hit him low, hit him high, it doesn't matter. Defenders ricochet off Tank Tasco at an alarming rate.
Jalen Alexander is part of that tackle for Monarch. Now first and goal. Can Denver South score first? Lindsay to the right side, no signal, and he didn't get in.
Little changeup, 25. Lindsay going back, taking the handoff, giving Super Pete a break. Tasco doing a great job ISOing on the linebacker. Colin Hart, number 24, does a good job of shedding the initial block by the fullback and making the play at the one-yard line.
See, Lindsay's number second and goal now. And Tollerson trying to sneak it in. He's in. Touchdown, Denver South.
South marches right down the field on the initial drive of the game, sticks it in the end zone. That is a statement drive right there for the Rebels.
13th rushing touchdown for the quarterback who wears number 6. And that makes it 6-0 Rebels. Take a look.
Double teaming the nose tackle at the point of attack, driving him into the end zone, letting your quarterback be the athlete he is, stretch it over, get 6 points. Great way to start.
And the extra point is up and good. As Suma makes it 7-0. What a start for the DPS school. Tollerson, 7-0 Rebels early on. Today's 4A state championship game on Root Sports is... Today's 4A state championship game on Root Sports is brought to you by the Ford Fiesta. With 40 miles per gallon, it's a pretty big deal. Ford Fiesta, go further. By Credit Union of Colorado, proud to support Colorado communities. By Brakes Plus, service you can trust at a price you can afford. And by Adams State University, where great stories begin. Higher education within your reach. Learn more at adams.edu. Rebels having a little fun Friday at the school, little pep rally. They had fun on their first drive. 7 plays, 2:52 off the clock, 82 yards. Tollerson with a 1 yard QB sneak.
Starting it off the right way with the huge run by Super Pete Williams right off the right side.
Suma with the kickoff, and that'll head in the end zone. So Monarch with their vaunted double wing will come on at the 20. Cole Watson is their senior quarterback. Notice he's only thrown the ball 35 times, but that's a product of this offense.
It is a product of the offense. He's a fantastic option quarterback, runs the double wing to a T, the son of a former Buffalo, and he really takes it on his shoulders to lead this football team up and down the field. He was very integral in that 23-play drive that they had against Pueblo West last week to advance to the authority today.
And it's Ethan Marks, number 7, the mark man. He almost broke it through to this second level, but gets 9 on first down.
And the pre-snap movement is a key, but at the same time, it's almost hard to read. And they're hurrying up, getting right back on the line of scrimmage, trying to really put pressure on the South defense with tempo and speed offensively.
On second and one, Logan Kidd-Sewell has the first down. And as we show you the starting lineups for the Monarch Coyotes, brought to you by Ford. They call him Kidd-Sewell, number 34, but his name's Logan, only a sophomore.
Another fine player in the backfield for Monarch. Hurst, the big offensive lineman, is really a beast up front and one of the guys that can really win one-on-one battles, very similar to what Denver South is going to want to do.
It's Marks again over the right side. He's got a hole. And a stiff arm brings him out to the 49.
Wow, the double team at the point of attack right there was outstanding on big number 55, Sam Mabini, moving the big man 3 to 4 yards back off the ball and then dumping him.
Marks
way to respond.
17 on that carry.
Way to respond here on this drive, coming out and hitting South right in the mouth.
And it's Sewell the other way, and he'll get 5 on first down.
And that's the thing about this. Once the stone starts rolling downhill with
right.
Monarch, it's really hard. I mean, a 5-yard gain, and you can almost say that was a positive for the defense.
As we said, keep an eye on Ethan Marks. He's the mark man. He's accounted for 65% of the Coyotes' offense, yards-wise, in the playoffs alone. And this is a quick hitter up the middle and near the sticks. Get you today's players to watch. Brought to you by your local Ford stores. When the Coyotes have the football, we've been mentioning Ethan Marks over and over, but Cole Watson, there are some nuances to being a quarterback in this system.
Yeah, you have to be very smart. You have three guys moving a lot of the time at the same time, and this up-tempo is really going to put a lot of pressure on him not to make mistakes. Saw the players to watch from South, Cameron French, a defensive player of the year in the state of Colorado. Just a fantastic player, 13 interceptions. But the thing is, Monarch doesn't throw the ball, ever. Monarch has 30-some pass attempts on the season. Cameron French is going to need to go up there and stick his nose in there and try and make some tackles today in order to be successful.
That is Monarch's head coach. There's Phil Bravo in his 15th year. As he came over from California back in 1991, coached at Centaurus, and has been at Monarch. And already has a title. That was 10 years ago.
Number 21, Lee Childs right there for Denver South did a good job stepping up and making a solid tackle to bring up second down. Third down.
Third and 5 from the 36. With the Coyotes throw here. We'll see.
Changing look.
Watson. Pitch. Marks. And there's Ethan Marks. Almost to the marker. Looks like he's about a yard short.
A.J. Harris, big number 90, holding on for dear life there on Marks, making a nice tackle. Look at the way number 90 sheds at the point of attack. Fights for the double team, sticks out a big paw, pulls down number 7, Marks, and he truly is a marked man today. Denver South knows if they want to win this football game and hoist a trophy, you've got to stop number 7.
4th and 2, and this is normal territory for the Coyotes. The pitch, Ethan Marks, and it looks like if the spot is okay, he should have enough.
By the nose of the football, it looks to be a first down.
And this is what Monarch does. They get another first down. They continue to move the sticks and the clock.
And not only do these long drives take a ton of time off the clock, but they tire out a defense. You're going to have to sub new guys in as they are doing right now. Number 44, Johnny Coleman of Denver South, did a nice job of stepping up and making a solid tackle, just an inch too short. Oh, a pass.
They're rolling out, and it's picked off. And that's French. Johnny on the spot. Flag on the play, and Cameron French steps out of the 40.
Speak of the devil, and he shall appear. Cameron French, we just said, 13 interceptions on the year. Defensive player of the year in the state of Colorado. Steps up, makes a massive play for his team after Monarch converts a fourth down right in the breadbasket. Maybe that's the reason they don't throw the ball very often.
The most passes Monarch has thrown in any single game is 7.
I like the play call. You pick up a first down on fourth. You line up in the same exact formation, the full house, and try and catch him off guard. Denver South doing a good job of showing discipline on defense. Cameron French in the right place at the right time. Number 2 stepping up, showing why he is the defensive player of the year.
Flag goes against the Rebels, holding on that return of the INT.
And that's what happens. Defensive guys get a little
on the return,
little amped up.
Holding on the defense. First down, Denver South.
You know all about that when you're running the other way, right?
Hey, you're so excited that you have the ball.
Denver South, a 7-0 lead and the ball when we come back.
7-6. Many members of the team were outstanding. Dr. Kent Hutchinson won the Gold Helmet Award and the Prep All-American status. Dr. Hutchinson is in attendance, and perhaps other members of the team. That year, South also won the state championships in track, baseball, and swimming. Just a little information for you. The Colorado High School Activities Association would like to take this opportunity to recognize advanced orthopedic and sports medicine specialists for their generous support of the association.
Actually,
it's time for extra credit from the Credit Union of Colorado. Let's tell you a little bit about Monarch's Henry Oliver, the senior left guard. 4.5 GPA, thinking about Colorado or Stanford after Monarch. Credit Union of Colorado will donate $500 to the school district's general scholarship fund on behalf of the Extra Credit Athlete of the Week. Become a Credit Union of Colorado member. Find out how today at cuofco.org. Cameron French. I asked you before the game started, what's he going to do? Because they don't pass the ball. Well, guess what? He picks off the first pass.
And this is why you just stay away from number two. Wherever he is on the field, do not throw the ball in that area. That's his 14th interception on the season. On the season. He leads the country, not just the state of Colorado. Defensive player of the year, like we've said a couple of times. He's the catalyst for that secondary and a playmaker. You can't supplement playmaking, and he's always in the right place at the right time. Hats off to Cameron French, another pick to the total.
He came into the game with 24 tackles and 13 interceptions.
When you only have 10 more tackles than you do interceptions, and those numbers are 24 and 14, that's saying something.
And look at Monarch, stand-up Pete Williams. Big play on first down for the Coyotes D.
James Haddle, number 28. Excuse me. Peter Mitchell, number 29, does a great job of standing in the hole and wrapping up Pete Williams. That's what you have to do to Super Pete. You have to wrap him up and get him on the ground. You try and arm tackle this kid, thinking he's just a scat back, and he will run through the arm tackle and break away with that 10.600-meter speed.
Pete Williams for a yard, met by Petey Mitchell. Second and nine from the 21. Tollison rolls right, looking for Lindsey. Throws it up into the middle of the field. It's Matisse Moore, the big tight end. Ball's on the ground. Coyotes think they have it. They do.
Great job by Monarch responding. South tries to move the pocket, does a good job of getting Tollison in space to make a play with his feet or his arm. He delivers a nice strike to his tight end. Two steps later, the ball's on the ground, and the Coyotes recover, matching a turnover with the turnover. You've got the ball back on the positive side of the 50-yard line, no doubt.
Watch Moore drop it, and Sewell recover it. Mitchell got a hand in there. Sewell's on it before Lindsey could get on it.
Good job by Mitchell tackling the football instead of the man.
Jake Hummel in on that hit as well. Great look as it hits.
It looks like Hummel on the super slow-mo there. It looks like Hummel's the one that punched it out. Fantastic job of tackling the football.
Marks drags a couple of tacklers on first down. Picks up a good four.
Johnny Coleman, 44. Third time we've called his name this afternoon so far. Flying to the football once again. Monarch is putting a lot of pressure on South right now by getting to the line and snapping the football within 10 seconds of the play clock running. So not only are they controlling the time of possession, but they are doing it with a lot of plays.
Watson with a keeper. Over 100 Colorado State Championship events are available for on-demand viewing anytime. All you have to do is go to chassatv.com. Your home for Colorado high school sports. Third and three. Marks, and should have enough again to move the sticks. As the quarter continues to move, they'll wind it up and approach 4 minutes left.
And most times when you're going against a running game, you have to deal with a puller, a guard maybe, a fullback coming through the hole. Monarch brings a fullback, a wingback, a backside tackle, a backside guard. They're running four guys through a hole, washing the whole the front side of the defensive line down. And then you've got bigger offensive linemen on smaller linebackers, and it after a while it becomes a battle of attrition. How much do you want to stick your face into the end of the mayhem down there if you're a safety or a corner if you're Denver South?
Sewell, left side, has an opening. Kid Sewell, 10, 5, touchdown, Monarch. 25 yards, and it's 7-6.
What a response by the Coyotes, getting a huge turnover and then making the most of it and scoring a big touchdown to even this thing up. Now, just like we said, Kid Marks getting the ball on the double wing sweep here. Not only are they doing that, but they're pulling the backside. They're leading with the fullback. You've got big guys on small guys at the second level. The Denver South defensive line needs to figure out how to shed some blocks and make some tackles in the backfield, or it's going to be a long day. The Monarch Coyotes can just sit there and bang the drum all day long with their running game.
Jamie Falloon on for the PAT. Trying to tie it up at 7, and he does. Through the uprights. You saw Sewell's numbers. He came into the game with close to 500 yards and 8 touchdowns. This is his 9th on the ground.
Hey, you're pulling a fullback, a guard, a tackle. You've got 4 guys leading the party down there for Kid Marks. The Red Sea just opens. And when you have that much space in front of you and no one touches you on a 20-plus yard touchdown run, that's impressive.
There was a pick, and then there was a fumble. Monarch able to capitalize. 3 plays, 36 yards. Kid Sewell with that 25-yard touchdown run. Coming up right after this game on Root Sports, it's the 5A Championship. Valor Christian and Cherokee Trail will battle it out. The best in high school football right here on Root Sports. We've had great games all season long, and that's a big one between a school from Aurora and a school from Highlands Ranch.
And there's some great players on the field for Cherokee Trail. The safety, Evan White, all Colorado player, great player. And you know the ensemble cast for Valor. Mount Gilbert in the middle, the nose tackle. Christian McCaffrey, the Gatorade Player of the Year, the Colorado Player of the Year. And Luke Del Rio, the consummate pro at the quarterback position, the quarterback of the year in the state of Colorado. So a lot of big names in that football game in the 5A contest.
Falloon with the kickoff. And this one will not be returned. Let's go down to the field again to check in with Torrey Holt.
Thanks, Mark. Hey, one of the guys you're not seeing in the game is Philip Lindsay, the outstanding star that headed to Colorado next year. I talked to him before the game, and a guy who blew out his knee back on August 31st, you thought would maybe be down with his teammates in the championship game and not having an opportunity. He couldn't stop grinning. The entire time I talked to him, he had a smile on his face. He's so happy for his teammates, and he felt like it was God's plan that allowed Pete Williams to be able to step up as a senior and have an opportunity to carry this team. He's so excited for him and also excited to go to see you next year and help turn around the program, guys.
All right, Torrey, and his Rebels back on offense. Tasco, the big sophomore, just bowls his way all the way up to the 32.
One of my favorite players in the state, Tate Tasco. The kid is 5'8", 270 pounds. 5'8", 270 pounds, that it may look a certain way on TV, but when you see this young man in person, he is
solid.
He is a 16-year-old grown man, folks, and he will embarrass you at the second level if you don't come full force on every single play.
From the 32 for the Rebels. And it's Tasco again. He bounces off over the 35 and just runs right over number 16. That's Jeff Clary.
Jeff Clary just found out the hard way just what it is to try and tackle an Abrams tank. Watching the super slow-mo here, does a great job leading with the shoulder, but the leg drive is what I want you to look at. It's a couple of oak trees down there just trouncing along step after step. The guy is an animal. There's a reason he's one of the top fullbacks in the state. Only a sophomore.
Clary had to come off with a stinger, and it's Lindsay who picks his way all the way up to midfield.
And this is the problem that South presents for people. They can beat you up with Tasco, and then they can put Lindsay at the fullback position, who's also a fantastic defensive player. Give him the ball, and he can become the more shifty, elusive fullback runner. And then you've got Super Pete Williams in the backfield as well. They can hit you in all three phases of the running game, plus their quarterback is mobile. What do you do exactly?
And Torrey just mentioned Philip Lindsay out with an ACL tear. That was just as things were getting going right around September 1st.
A lot of folks wrote him off after that, too. A lot of folks thought that the Rebels would crumble without their star player. I think it really brought this team together and made them better. Unfortunately,
looking long from Mosley, has a step. That's picked off. What an interception. as Jalen Alexander comes down with it for the Coyotes.
And Alexander did a great job of high-pointing the football, but also staying with the coverage. This is the second or third time we've seen South use the play action to try and open things up down the field. Now watch. Tolleson does a good job setting everything up. He has good protection, putting it up there for his outstanding wide receiver, Mosley, to make a play. Alexander just does a better job of going after the football. Alexander turns into the receiver right here on the super slow-mo when Mosley needs to turn it into the defender. Instead of trying to catch that, if you're number seven, Mosley, go up, knock it out of the hands of Alexander so you can live to play another down. This is back-to-back turnovers on two drives for South. Monarch has really shown some life here after getting ran over on the initial drive.
There's a good look at the junior. He's been involved in the two turnovers as Ethan Marks goes to the left side, keeps his feet, and out to about the 18. We're under 3 minutes to go here in the quarter. Here's Marks going to the left side.
Tight splits and then just get off. The offensive line for Monarch is nasty at the point of attack. When you're, and the quarterback is leading the way as well. I mean, the true heart of a Buffalo right there, his father played at CU. When your quarterback is leading the way and the lead blocker, you've got a tough team.
Marks again. And enough for a first down. It's pushed up to about the 22.
Thing about this Monarch offensive line, their splits are foot to foot. There is absolutely no space in between them. And they roll off the football. They don't step. They roll. And if you're in the way, I'm sorry, but you might get run over.
Matt, we've been talking about run against pass. In this game, there have been four pass plays. Three have resulted in turnovers. Two picks and a fumble.
Maybe everybody should just stick to the running game. A lot of 9-on-7 was practiced leading up to this one, no doubt.
2 minutes to go, and Sewell, and he is hit right at the point of attack. That's Taylor Williams, the senior for the Rebels.
6'3", 260-pound Taylor Williams does a good job of doing just what we said South needed to do. Make plays at the line of scrimmage. When you let Monarch get to the second level, that's when you get the huge chunks. Nice wrap-up, taking down the running back in the backfield. Huge play for South because now you only have three plays to get 10 yards. It's doable, no doubt. Monarch can get yards in big chunks. At the same time, though, keeping them at the line of scrimmage, second down and 10, that's an accomplishment.
From the 22. And a short gain on second down, maybe a couple of yards for Ethan Marks. As he gets up from the pile.
Now here's the predicament for Monarch. When you don't throw the ball well, and the one time you've thrown it today, it was picked off by Cameron French, number two for South. What do you do on third and 7+?
We're going to find out. They're going to pitch it out and only pick up a couple of yards.
Big play by the South defense to rise up and keep Monarch from picking up the first down. I can't imagine that Coach Bravo would go for it in this kind of territory, and here comes the punt team.
There's big Sam Mabany, saw number 55 for Denver South, heading to New Mexico.
He is a raw talent, too. That kid is long. He's got great speed. He's a long strider, and you could put a good 50-60 pounds on his frame. He's got an NFL prototype body right there for Sam Mabany, 55.
Jeff Clary to punt it away. Cameron French back deep, and this is shanked, and it's going to take a bounce, and here's French. Makes a move and picks up a couple 3 yards, steps out at about the 47.
Every time number two touches the ball, everyone on Monarch's sideline holds their breath. That's the danger of Cameron French. Whether it's the punt game, the return game, or interceptions, fumble returns, Cameron French is a dangerous man with the ball in his hands.
Oh, yeah, he's also had 6 receptions on offense, 2 for scores.
It's just, hey, when you're a playmaker, you're a playmaker. It doesn't matter where you play. I'm sure that they could put French at running back and he would still make plays. That's just the way he is.
Should be the last play of the first quarter of this 4A title game.
Double tight, I formation here for South.
Pete Williams makes a move. Williams, and gets hit at the 38 and stopped there. And close to the first down marker, but that will do it for the first quarter from Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Yep, where the Broncos play, we have a 7-all football game. Denver South scored first. Monarch answered. It's the 4A Championship on Root Sports. Together, hand in hand, side by side, dreams become real when shared. A family is built with love and respect, and purpose becomes clear with unconditional support. Brothers are never forgotten. It's Championship Saturday on Root Sports. From Sports Authority Field at Mile High, Mark Stout, Matt McChesney, Torrey Holt, Monarch, Denver South, Coyotes and Rebels, 7-all. As we begin the second quarter, Rebels with a screen, Mosley. And Mosley picks up enough for the first down. And we head back down to the sidelines and Torrey Holt. Torrey.
Yeah, you know, I'm on Denver South sideline here, and I was listening to Art Walker, the D-line coach, talking to his D-line. He really wants them to start running more twists, squeeze on those tight ends. And he was talking to Sam Mabini, the kid headed to New Mexico. He's so tall, he says, you got to dip. And you got to rip. You got to get low to get through that and get penetration, guys.
All right, Torrey. Dip and rip. First down. Williams rips it off to the left side. 30. And up to the 21. Another first down for the Rebels.
Nice stretch play here. Outrunning the pursuit of the Monarch Coyote defense. Going right behind one of their best offensive linemen, Big Mike Williams, number 78, who has himself won. Mean streak, to say the least. Now, going back to the defensive line for South, their name, Art Walker, great defensive lineman at the University of Colorado. When Art Walker speaks to you, if you're a defensive lineman for South, you better be listening. That man knows what he's talking about, no doubt.
From the 22, flag on the play, Williams up to the 10. And over the 10, we'll see what the flag is all about as Williams runs strong up the middle. Flag back at about the 25, just beyond the line of scrimmage. And it's against the Rebels, so bring that run back.
And even though it comes back, it still just happened. I mean, Monarch can't take away the fact. I know that the yards don't count, but they can't take away the fact that they just got gashed again.
5-yard penalty from the previous spot, replay first down.
Even though they have turned the ball over with a fumble and an interception, speaking of South, on their play-action attempts this afternoon. Monarch is definitely noticing that they are going play-action. They're keeping safeties deep. They're not really playing up on the wide receivers very physically. Just being very aware of the possibility of play-action.
Williams on first and 15. More flags as he gets hit at about the 15.
And this one is definitely going to be a hold in the middle of the offensive line.
There's Jeff Bergstrom, our referee here. A big line for Denver South. You mentioned Mike Williams, 6'5", 315. Michael Barfield, Darius Chorey in the middle.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty, spot of the foul. Replay first down.
Tony Lindsay said that Barfield and Chowry, 67 and 79, partners in crime. They kind of took things over and got this line going.
And the offensive line for South is big. They're physical. They're nasty. But they also pride themselves on getting opportunities for their fantastic backfield, from Tasco to Lindsay to Pete Williams. Those three owe their success to the big, physical, mean offensive line in front of them, although they have made two back-to-back mistakes, which has backed them up about 35 yards here. Need to play contain, all right? There's a difference between trying to play physical and play mean and then playing, you know, kind of knuckleheaded. You can't block people while holding them and throwing them to the ground in front of the referee. They're always going to call that.
Timeout on the field as Tony Lindsay talks to his offense after some flags. And with that timeout, we're going to take a timeout as well. It's tied at 7 here in the second quarter. It's the 4A title game on Root Sports. South quarterback Malik Tollerson with a one-yard run early on. And then Kid Sewell from 25 yards out from Monarch. We are tied at 7 with 10:27 to go here in the second quarter of the 4A championship.
Both teams, Monarch with 100 yards rushing already and South with 121. A heavy emphasis on the run game here. That's for sure. It's what we expected, though, as well.
They're going to throw on first down. Tollerson forced out. Now steps up, has room to run it, but he throws, looking long. Chambers, that's picked off, but maybe out of bounds. Clary came down with it. And it looks like we'll talk it over and see if it's an interception from Monarch.
Very interesting to see here on the replay. If he was in bounds, if this was a Bronco game, I guarantee you that one's going to review. He could have been bobbling that as well, going out of bounds. Nonetheless, a great play in the secondary for Monarch.
Yeah, Clary right here comes down with it, takes it away from Chambers.
Ah, that's an interception. He has control and his foot is down. South just got away with one. Great play by Clary of Monarch. High pointing the football once again. Second time we've seen the Coyote secondary high point the ball.
Clary, number 16, is a senior. His brother Matt was on the Monarch team that won it all 10 years ago.
And look at this foot right there. There it is. And the right as well. He gets 2 feet down with control. South just got a break.
Draw for Lindsay on second down. Goes nowhere.
Wow. Physical football at the point of attack. Whoo. They are banging heads out there today.
Josh Hurst in there. You see the senior lineman.
James Hattle, number 28, laying the wood as well.
Just big number 72, 6 foot, 290. And a 3.9 GPA. Well, you can say that about everybody on Monarch.
Very, very smart football team, no doubt.
There's Hurst, who plays both ways.
And don't think that doesn't play into it. Coach Bravo wants smart kids that can handle, you know, an intricate defensive system and a very complicated. I know that the double wing looks easy, but it is very complicated to run.
And we get a flag that's going to be a delay game.
Prior to the snap, delay on the offense. 5-yard penalty remains third down.
Let's go down to Torrey Holt. You were there right in front of the interception.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to bail out the officials on this, too. The first official was his call on the sideline. He was coming down towards the end zone. Immediately he said, I can't see it. I don't see it. I don't see it. And he was waving his arm saying, I don't see it. It went to the guy in the end zone. He didn't see that either. It wasn't his call. So it was real tough on the officials.
They're going to throw on third and long. And now Tollerson out of the pocket. And there's a flag on the play that's going to go against, I think, Tank Tasco. As he got tangled up with one of the Coyotes.
And if Denver South could just stop getting penalties, maybe they could progress down the field. At this point, I might just punt it at third down and stop the bleeding on this drive. And this is one of the ugliest drives that we've seen out of South all year. Great field.
Tollerson.
Holding on the offense. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
Tank Tasco, number 9, getting a little eager out here. Right there, the big man.
Yeah, he gets tangled up.
Definitely grabbing the defender and pulling him down. That's one of the things. When you get to a second-level defender to block him, you need to stop your feet, set yourself, and strike with your hands. When you block with your hands at any level, it ends up being a holding penalty 95% of the time.
And the punt on fourth down heads to the end zone. And so Monarch's going to take over with the game tied at 7-all. When we come back, Cole Watson and the Coyotes with the football trying to take the lead. Take you on a tour of the Denver South campus. Classes were first held in 1893, the old Grant Building, now Grant Middle School, and the first graduating class 1926. You know some of the alumni you see there. Diana DeGette is on there. Former Rapids player Connor Casey, who won an MLS championship here in Denver, and you see the enrollment up to over 1,300. And the Rebels and the Coyotes are tied at 7 with 9:16 to go here. In the first half of the 4A title game, Monarch back on offense. It's Ethan Marks again. And tripped up maybe a yard or two for Ethan Marks.
Childs, number 21, the outstanding linebacker for South, stepping up and making an ankle tackle, holding them to only 2 yards. Hey, you saw in that graphic, Calais Campbell.
From Arizona.
That plays in Arizona. Went to South, went to the U down in Miami. So there's a great tradition of good defensive football here at Denver South. These defensive linemen up front definitely need to control this football game for South to have a chance.
Mark spins out of a tackle and gets it up over the 25 to about the 27. So, Matt, you got a third down here. I mean, best case scenario, Coyotes, they'd like to take most of this clock off and get to halftime with a lead.
And as you watch the replay, we'll tell you that it is third and 3, and they are back on the football.
Not much doing there.
Great
on third
play
down.
By South. Looks like a little miscommunication there, one of the negatives of going hurry up. Little miscommunication there by Monarch. It brings up fourth and three on a no gain. This is very risky. If you're going to go for this, Coach Bravo is pretty much telling his football team, look, offensive line, we are all in. We are all in to win the state title. This is a massive play. Don't be surprised if they try and drive them off sides.
Crowd coming to life at Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Watson barking out the signal, stands up, looks to Phil Bravo. And they're going to take a timeout.
And there you go. Trying to draw South off sides, seeing that they have committed a countless number of penalties here in the first half already in this football game. Trying to see if they would be undisciplined on the defensive side of the ball. I'm sure that the defensive line coach, Big Art Walker, down there for South, is very pleased that his defensive linemen watch the ball. I'd rather say whoa than sick 'em every day.
With a timeout, we have a chance to get you our Breaks Plus poll question. The results from last week, we asked which team you think would win the 5A title. And it's Valor by a landslide. 75% to 25%. We'll have that game coming up right after this game as the Eagles and the Cougars will do battle.
It'll be called by Mr. Drew Gribman and Cedric Bonner. They're going to do a great job bringing you Valor and Cherokee Trail. Cherokee Trail has a tall task in front of them, no doubt. Valor is explosive, and they run a very, very professional system over there for the Eagles. They are not messing around on the defensive or offensive side of the ball. You know, Coach Wieselmeyer is a defensive coordinator. Very rare for a head coach.
On fourth and three, Marks. And Ethan Marks trying to struggle to the markers. Not going to get it.
And he's going to be about a yard short. South raises to the occasion. Big number 90, A.J. Harris, anchoring the defensive line in there. Sam Mabee, number 55. Taylor Williams, number 52. Number 78, Mike Williams, they do a great job of standing up, controlling the line of scrimmage, and getting off the field. And this is the problem if you're Monarch. Punt the football. Your defense is playing great, great right now in this football game. They're exceptional up front. They're doing a great job in the back end, controlling the play action. Why give them this kind of field position? Punt the ball and flip the field. Very risky.
7:40, you counting from the 29. And a flag again before they can get the playoff.
Prior to the snap, called start. Offense. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
And Coach Tony Lindsay is going to be steaming hot at halftime with the amount of penalties that his football team has committed thus far in this football game. It's unacceptable at this point. The leaders on this team need to calm everybody down in the huddle and start executing. You're giving up a lot of yardage, but not only that, you're giving up explosive plays because of bonehead penalties.
That's the fifth penalty on the Rebels. Tasco keeps his feet going, still moving, and finally dragged out at the 35-yard line. He wasn't going down.
Great job by the Coyotes of rallying. That's what you have to do against Tank Tasco. If you're going to try and tackle an Abrams tank, you better do it with about nine guys. And you see at the end of this clip here in the super slow-mo, there's four, five, six Coyotes in the frame here for Monarch. That's the way you have to attack South in their dynamic running game. Get hats to the football.
I saw Sewell, Stockebrand, Sanders, second and 15. Lindsay bounces off a tackler. And over the 30, that's big Pete Williams, actually. Pete Williams with a nice run, going to bring up third down and about seven.
What a stiff arm by Super Pete there at the point of attack. And he's not stiff arming a linebacker. He's stiff arming a big defensive tackle. Get off me. I got running to do. Pete Williams accelerating through the hole and putting South in a manageable third down here.
Eight carries for 63 yards for Williams so far in this 4A title game. Tollerson keeps, turns it up. And Tollerson fumbles the football. Monarch says they have it, another turnover. And the Coyotes get the football back.
Number 66, John Palm, stepping up and recovering the fumble there on the drop by the quarterback, Tollerson. That's one of the risks you run on option football when you're not used to it.
6:15 to go here in the first half. Another turnover by Denver South. The Rebels and the Coyotes are tied at 7 in the 4A championship. Championship Saturday is brought to you by Gatorade. The G-Series fuels Championship Saturday. Prime, perform, recover. Championship Saturday is brought to you by Gatorade. The G-Series fuels Championship Saturday. Prime, perform, recover. Wells Fargo, when you're going for the win, Wells Fargo is with you. Together, we'll go far. AT&T Mobility, AT&T 4G LTE has you covered. Part of the nation's largest 4G network. The Denver Post, a proud sponsor of the Colorado Sports Hall of Fame and Colorado High School Activities Association. Back in downtown Denver, a beautiful December the 1st for Championship Saturday here on Root Sports as Monarch takes over the football up the middle, and that's Papp, who we haven't called his name yet. Braden Papp, the junior, with a big run on first down.
And Monarch says we have our own hammer, and Papp, number 15, does just that. Hits him right off the bat with the quick hitter to the fullback out of the full house look. Nice pull by the offensive line, setting the edge. Cameron French having to get a little dirty there and stick his nose in there and make a tackle on a bigger fullback.
Marks the 32, maybe a yard, maybe two. Monarch, fifth seeded. They were the preseason number one team in 4A. And South, the number three seed, Rebels and the Coyotes. There's Phil Bravo, who at one point coached Eric Bieniemy, the former CU star.
Yeah, he's definitely paid his dues through the coaching ranks. Starting off in California.
And he's been running this offense for 27 years. Again, it's Papp. And again, a nice gain. It's going to bring up third and about two. Here's Monarch's playoff history. I mentioned a decade ago, the champs. And when you talk about Monarch in the postseason, they've been in the playoffs every year since 2002. The only other teams that can say that, Roston Valley and Thunder Ridge. And those are 5A teams now.
And when you make the playoffs every single year in the 4A division, where you don't have, you know, 35, 40 teams getting into the playoffs like it is in the 5A division, there's something to be said for that. Now, we're right back to the same situation we were just in, fourth and two. It looks as if Coach Bravo is going to just go all in again and rely on his offense to pick up this yardage. My thing is, and this may work, it might not. I guess we'll see in a second. My thing is, you can only play with fire so many times before you get burned. And South is not going to keep shooting themselves in the foot consistently.
Marks. And he's got a first down and more as French drags him down at about the 48.
And I'll tell you what, right now, the Monarch front and number 55, Henry Oliver, the left guard, he is absolutely destroying the South defense on his pulls. They are pulling 55 consistently, and he is running over and setting the edge on defensive ends and linebackers at the next level. Hats off to number 55, Henry Oliver. He's doing a great job of leading the way here for the Monarch offense.
Marks with the quarterback Watson in front of him. And into Denver South territory. Yeah, that line of Austin Beswick, Henry Oliver, Logan Shapiro, Levi Ensign, Josh Hurst, tight-knit group. A lot of them play baseball. They are always together 24-7.
Tight-knit group with tight splits, and that's the thing. They condense the field from a width perspective, and they make you play physical smash-mouth football. A lot of teams can't hold up. Denver South is doing a pretty decent job at this point.
Tap again. Little direction snap up the middle. Coyotes fans down from the Louisville area. Yeah, they play their home games at Centaurus High School, which is where Phil Bravo originally started coaching in Colorado, and they won on that field last week as they were able to kind of corral Derek Jackson.
Derek Jackson, the running back of the year in the state of Colorado, a fantastic player from Pueblo West, ran for 3,300 yards.
Right.
3,343 yards. That is ridiculous.
Rebels think they have the football, but it's going to be ruled down. So Monarch is now 0 of 6 on third down, but it's another fourth down situation. You mentioned Derek Jackson. We're going to talk about him at halftime coming up, and we'll tell you about big 6-0s all Colorado team.
That's right. Stay tuned. Another big fourth down, fourth and two.
Ethan Marks resets. The double wing, and another timeout coming up for Monarch. So Phil Bravo will walk out and talk about it.
No problem with using your timeouts in the first half. None at all, especially when, you know, you're pretty much in a two-minute offense because you do not throw the ball at all. You know, at 2:25, you're trying to have the best play available to be called to convert this fourth down, so you can't keep the drive moving and try and get 3-7 going in at the half.
Just getting things underway here on this big sports day. Coming up tonight on Root Sports, it's exciting college basketball. Wyoming hosting the number 19 CU Buffs. Colorado going up to Laramie. That'll be at 8 o'clock tonight. We'll tip it off. Don't miss your favorite college basketball here on Root Sports. CU and the Cowboys.
Tad Boyle has done a hell of a job up there in Boulder building that program. And they are only going to get better. The foundation was laid last year. And, you know, they have some great young talent up here, up in Boulder, and it's become a basketball school. Kind of pains me to say that a little bit, but, hey, I'm supportive. The Roll Tad, no doubt.
That's Boulder. We're in downtown Denver. Fourth and two. Monarch fans coming to life. And the pitch, and it's Kid Sewell, and the kid gets it done up to the 40. Clock continues to run. This is what Monarch does best.
And this wears on a defensive front. It wears on a defensive coordinator. Sooner or later, you start trying to call tricky things on defense to just spark maybe a turnover or a big play for your defensive football team. And that's when Monarch, doing the same thing over and over again, is going to hit you with a huge seam.
18th carry of the title game for Ethan Marks. And a nice pickup on first down. When you talk about this Monarch team, Matt, since that 2002 title, they come into this game with a record of 107-15.
Wow. 107-15. Break out my T1000 calculator real quick.
I see the steam coming out of your
ear. It's like kryptonite to me, man. I can barely count.
Quick hitter up the middle, maybe a yard. Another third down coming up.
Nice job by 55, Sam Mabany, an all-Colorado defensive end for Denver South, making a big play. A.J. Harris, number 90, also in there, standing up his offensive lineman and making a big play. One thing that Denver South might want to consider is going to more of a bare front, where they cover up the all three gaps inside, both A-gaps with a nose tackle and two defensive linemen, so you don't have the huge seams.
Boy, Marks bounces off, and some tough yards flagged on the play. If so, it'll be an automatic first down if it goes for Monarch, because that was third and four. That was the 10th play of this drive.
In the range of a face mask, when you see a defender reach out and the head move on the ball carrier, it's usually a face mask, and it is. Watch here in the super slow-mo.
Unintentional face mask on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Result of the play is a first down.
Marks does a good job of making something out of nothing after getting hit in the backfield, spinning away, and getting up the field. You take a four-yard gain and tack on five. There's an extra 9 yards, and you're moving the football. Now, we got a minute 13 left in the half here, and Monarch doesn't throw the ball a whole lot, so I'm very interested to see if they open it up a little bit and try and score a touchdown or if they're content with just three. Here we go.
Monarch over the 20, and French runs him out at the 8-yard line.
The double teams at the point of attack right now for Monarch are absolutely annihilating the defensive front for Denver South. Coach Art Walker, the defensive line coach for Denver South, is not going to be pleased with how high his defensive linemen are playing, but also the movement that Monarch is getting on them. They are really blowing the defensive line off the ball. And Marks, number seven, is doing a great job of exploiting the holes that are opened by this fantastic offensive front for Monarch.
Marks, you see him right there within 4 yards of 100 here in the game.
100 by halftime, not bad.
Speaking of halftime, let's tell you what's coming up. I'm going to talk about the All-Colorado team that Matt was involved with and his 6-0 strength training. It was a great event this week. We'll preview the 5A championship between Valor and Cougar. Highlights and stats from the first half, too, brought to you by Adams State University, where great stories begin.
Little number here for you, folks. Monarch, no penalties. Obviously, no yardage lost. South, 3 turnovers. And 6 penalties for 58 yards. That's the difference in this football game right now. It's 7-7, yes. The difference in this game is Monarch is playing mistake-free, pretty much turnover-free football during this first half, whereas Denver South is playing overly aggressive, making mistakes in alignment, not tackling very well. I mean, they're doing an okay job, but they're turning the ball over, and they're killing themselves with penalties. That's not the way to win a championship.
First and goal from the 8. And it's Marks with Watson in front of him. And Ethan Marks pounds his way down to the 4-yard line. So Monarch, with a timeout left, they're going to manage the clock and obviously try to get it to halftime with the lead. They haven't led in this game. Denver South scored first in the first quarter.
See, Marks, 20 rushes for now 100 yards on the afternoon. 100 yards by halftime, you can never frown about that.
It's Marks right back again. And Ethan Marks in for the touchdown.
And when you have Henry Oliver, number 55, blocking his defensive lineman 6 yards into the end zone and then dumping him, beating his running back to the end zone coincidentally, that's saying something about your football team. The physical nature of this drive to close out the first half has really been impressive by the Coyotes.
Well, look at Oliver just plowing away.
Oliver's really showing me something in this ball game. Not only is he athletic, getting out on poles and really kicking out defensive ends and leading up on linebackers, but he's tenacious. Once he gets his hands on you, he's trying to finish. I love that about an offensive lineman. Great job.
Jamie Falloon on for the PAT. Up and good. Make it 14-7 Monarch with 33 seconds until halftime.
What a great response by the Coyotes.
There's your scoring drive. 13-play drive, 5:42 off the clock, and Ethan Marks with his 21st rushing touchdown of this season.
Now watch Henry Oliver right there, the big man, number 55, finishing the block, taking number 44, Johnny Coleman, all the way into the end zone. You can see the look of discouragement on South's faces. They're walking off the field. They're angry about the fact that they just gave up a long touchdown drive consisting of 13 plays. I would love to see the play total, the play count total, if our stat man Pete can get me that number, as opposed to the total yardage or anything like that. Monarch is running a ton of plays, assaulting the Denver South defense, whereas Denver South is more conventional, huddling up and taking their time, and they're turning the ball over and getting a lot of penalties. Monarch's been on the field offensively this whole half.
So the Coyotes, familiar to being in this situation, haven't trailed at the half as Jamie Falloon tees it up. Ethan Marks now has 7 touchdowns in Monarch's 4 playoff games with that run. So here we go as Falloon will kick it off. And a little pop-up kick, something that could go the way of Monarch if they can get on it. And Denver South, I can't believe they let that bounce.
Wow.
You know what happened last week against Pueblo West was Monarch scored at the end to take a 14-6 lead, had to kick it off in a similar situation about a minute plus to go. Kicked that same type of kickoff and recover the ball.
And that goes back to film study. Obviously, Coach Bravo found something on film, and Denver South obviously did not watch that clip. You've got guys just standing around waiting for somebody to cover up the ball on South's kickoff return team, whereas Monarch is sprinting down the field. That could have been a game changer right there. You give them the ball with 30 seconds left inside the 30, and you have a real problem if you're South. Another set of flags.
Substitution infraction. 12 men on the field. The offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
I can tell you this right now, Mark. I can guarantee you this if you're a Denver South football fan. The coach of the year, Coach Tony Lindsay, is going to be steaming hot at halftime with the way his team has played thus far in this football game. Unmistakable mistakes all over the field. I know that that sounds stupid, excuse me, but big-time mistakes all over the field.
Pete Williams keeps his feet, and Kid Sewell brings him down at the 41. Now there's 22 seconds left. Denver South does have a timeout.
22 seconds left here in the half. Huge run by Pete Williams. Get him out to about the 40-yard line. At this point, you may want to try and pick up big chunks of yards easily if you trust your kicker.
Well, they start up the clock, and South now getting to the line. Under 15 seconds to go as we watch Williams in his long run. Williams again, and he is stuffed. And Denver South will take a timeout with 3 seconds to go.
Wow, what a nice tackle. Great job of forming up the ball carrier.
Petey Mitchell coming up, number 29, hits number 28 right here.
That's the way to tackle, folks. Finish through the man, head up, drive your feet. That's how you counter a fantastic running back in Pete Williams. You tackle through the man. You don't try and run to him and grab.
Well, it was a decade ago when Monarch won the 4A title. They beat Golden in a shootout, a game that was tied at 28 going into the fourth quarter. And this year, Monarch had a little reunion of 15 players and coaches from that team from a decade ago. And they beat Golden this year 49-0.
Big thanks to our stat man, Pete. We were talking about total plays in the first half. Monarch has 38 total plays in the first half. South only has 25. Now, if you equate that to what's going to go on in the second, you're going to have Monarch running close to 80, 85 plays during this football game, whereas South may only get 50 opportunities, judging by what we've seen. I know this is the 26th play of the half for South. Judging by what we've seen, they're only going to get about 50 to 55 snaps. You can't go and shoot yourself in the foot with penalties and turnovers every time.
Timeout, Monarch, third and final timeout.
Phil Bravo going to take a timeout. His defensive coordinator is Aaron Paddock, who's been with him since that championship back in 2002, and they'll talk it over.
And he's got this defense playing the right way. They are playing physical. They are not missing opportunities to make tackles. And really, they're doing a great job of not biting on the play action. They're keeping their guys back, knowing that Denver South has shown the ability to beat people over the top of play action to Mosley, out of the backfield to Williams and Tasco. They do a great job of getting the ball into their playmakers' hands. Now, Monarch is interesting because those 38 plays that they've run, Coach Bravo said probably four or five times on the conference call earlier this week, they have to control the time of possession and limit mistakes. And they are doing that. They are limiting mistakes and controlling the top. Hats off in the first half here for Monarch.
He said they would be poised and they would play assignment football.
Denver South is kind of buying into the hype of this game here. There's a difference between playing physical and beating up your man and being smart about it and trying to play too physical and forgetting about your assignment.
And that falls incomplete as they try to hit Pete Williams, and that's how this first half is going to end, with Monarch up by a touchdown, 14-7.
Great first half for the Coyotes. Not a very good first half for the Denver South Rebels. I'm sure that there's going to be two different types of talks at halftime from Bravo and Lindsay, respectively.
Speaking of Phil Bravo, he's with the head coach of the Coyotes, Torrey.
Yeah, thanks, Mark. Coach, admittedly, before the game, you were a little bit nervous coming into it, and rightfully so, a very good Denver South team, but you have a 14-7 lead. How are the nerves now?
Still there. I mean, been here before, let it happen. Well, you know, keep playing great defense and keep their defense on the field.
What's been the key to your offensive line? Really been leaning on him the last couple of series.
We're in pretty good shape, so we're hoping the heat gets him. It's hotter than heck down here, so we hope the heat really gets to him.
Coach, appreciate your time. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
All right, Phil Bravo, still nervous, but right now his team up 14-7.
All right, Tori, yeah, it is a sunny Saturday, December the 1st in downtown Denver. As the Mohai football team has the lead at the half over Denver South. Coyotes and the Rebels going at it in the 4A championship game here on Root Sports. Halftime coming up next. So far, so good for the team from the north over the team from the DPS. 14-7 Monarch at the half. It is halftime of the 4A championship game on Root Sports, and Monarch, the Coyotes, with a 14-7 lead over the Denver South Rebels. Welcome back, Mark Stout, Matt McChesney. I call him 6-0. He runs 6-0 strength and training. You wore 6-0 in high school. We've got a high school game here and in college, and you had a great event at your place this past week where you named an all-Colorado high school football team.
Yeah, the 6-0 strength and fitness all-Colorado team, as seen here on Root Sports. It was a great event, and we had a great showing, packed house, over 200 guys. Friends and family were involved, and it was really just to give back to the kids and honor some of the young men that you've seen all year en route go out here and play their butts off. A great event.
We just saw Christian McCaffrey there, and McCaffrey, the Gatorade Player of the Year, and also your Player of the Year, as you explained some of the awards.
We had about 48 guys get honored here at the 6-0 Strength and Fitness All-Colorado team. And really some big names. Chris Fox won the Colorado MVP. He's going to Michigan. Concrete Charlie, the best two-way player in the state of Colorado. Dominic Rail from Wheat Ridge, a guy that you've seen here on Route a couple of times. Comeback Player of the Year, Davion Amos White from Wheat Ridge after that devastating knee injury. Really, the Gold 16 Adversity Award goes to Zach Goldich Gateway. And it's for the guy that overcame the most to achieve the most on the field. He's going to CSU. You know, the young man that was shot in the theater through the neck and is still with us and had a great season. He got a standing ovation
from
over 200 people in the house the other night. Coach of the Year, Tony Lindsay, here for Denver South. I'm sure that he's chewing some butts at halftime right now.
This is your all-Colorado team when we look at offense and specialty players.
And the highlighted players that you see here are the players of the year at their respective positions. Chris Fox on the offensive line. Mitch Parsons from Chaparral is your receiver of the year. Christian McCaffrey, the offensive player of the year. Derek Jackson, the senior from Pueblo West, the running back of the year. Luke Del Rio, the consummate pro, gets quarterback of the year from Valor. A great team, and I would put this squad against anybody's all-Colorado team in the state of Colorado, I bet you mine will come out on top.
That was one of the neat things of that event, about changing the culture here in Colorado and getting high school football even more on the map.
You got to give back at the basement level for anything to change at higher levels. You know, you look at the defense here, the all-Colorado defense, Colin Albuchard from Mullen, the Punisher, as I call him, wins Defensive Lineman of the Year. Derek Landis, over 190 tackles, that's right, 190. The senior for Lakewood wins Linebacker of the Year, and the great Cameron French, number two out here for Denver South, the secondary player of the year of the all-Colorado high school football team, also the defensive player of the year, so he took home a lot of hardware. The overall message that we were trying to get across to these young men is if you accomplish things and you work your butt off, you're going to get rewarded for it. And there's really a lack of accountability here and some apathy covering, you know, the high school athlete here out here in the state. So we're trying to change the culture from the bottom to the top. And if you give back, you get a ton. The 6-0 strength all-Colorado team here on Root Sports, the best in the business.
Matt, nice work this past week.
Thank you, sir.
It was an excellent event.
It was great to give back.
You saw some names on there from Valor Christian and also Cherokee Trail. Hey, there are the Cougars getting ready for the 5A championship game. We'll preview it when we come back. It's halftime of the 4A title game on Root Sports. Well, after a half in the 4A championship game, it's Monarch over Denver South 14-7. Right after this game, the 5A title game. Valor Christian. And Matt, you know all about Christian McCaffrey. We saw him run rampant, catch balls, and return them.
And note to Cherokee Trail, do not let number five out of your sight. Don't punt him the ball, don't kick him the ball, and you better have two guys on him at all times. He is the manimal. Christian McCaffrey, the Offensive Player of the Year on the 6-0 Strength and Fitness team, also the Gatorade Player of the Year. It's well-deserved. He's the best player in the state of Colorado with the ball in his hands. Unstoppable.
Cherokee Trail does have an athletic and quick defense, though, Matt.
Oh, no doubt. The fantastic safety for Cherokee Trail, Evan White, all-Colorado player on the 6-0 Strength and Fitness team. He's a downhill threat, and he's really the leader on that defensive side of the ball. He's going to have a huge game. Cherokee Trail rallies to the football. They're great tacklers, and they have two defensive ends that really get up the field and apply a lot of pressure. You need pressure on Del Rio and solid tackling in order to win that football game.
Valor going for their fourth straight title. Cherokee Trail there first. That game follows this game. We've got first half stats and highlights when we come back to Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Well, it's halftime of the 4A title game. Each team with a loss this year. And Monarch leading at the half, 14-7, as we get you back here to Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Mark Stout and Matt McChesney. And a lot of penalties in the first half really kind of affected South in the way they did things.
And South played an ugly half of football. They shot themselves in the foot with three turnovers. They had countless penalties, alignment mistakes, false starts, face masks. They're playing aggressive and they're playing hard. They're just not playing smart. And Coach Tony Lindsay, the coach of the year in the state of Colorado, I guarantee you this, he definitely chewed some butt at halftime. He does not stand for bonehead football.
Let's get you the first half highlights brought to you by Adams State University, where great stories begin. It began well enough for the Rebels. Malik Tollerson with a sneak.
And they go all the way down the field on the opening possession of the game and stick it in the end zone for a 7-0 lead. You see the lone pass by Monarch, resulting in a Cameron French interception, coincidentally his 14th of the season, the defensive player of the year in the state of Colorado stepping up. And then the turnover bug hits South.
Yeah, Matisse Moore makes the catch, but the tight end puts it on the ground.
And they don't go back to the tight end after that. And then right afterwards, Monarch exploits the mistake and takes it in for a tie-up touchdown to make it 7-7.
And guess what? More mistakes come in the way of the Rebels as this goes. Look at this pick by Alexander.
And Alexander high points the football over the great wide receiver for South, Mosley. The second turnover for South. And then South on the move again. Tollison gets hit from behind, coughs it up. Monarch takes that fumble down the field, and it results in this.
Yeah, they drive all the way down, leave 33 seconds on the clock. Ethan Marks, 21st touchdown on the ground this year.
And Ethan Marks is a marked man, but he's been doing a great job of staying consistent during this game, over 100 yards already.
All right, time now for the Adams State first half stats. Higher education within reach at Adams State University. Learn more at adams.edu.
The penalties is what I want you to focus on, folks. 7 penalties for 53 yards for South, and some drive killers in there as well. No penalties for Monarch. 3 turnovers for South, only 1 for Monarch. 3 of 4 on fourth down conversions. They're not converting third downs, they're converting fourth downs. So these drives and the amount of plays that Monarch is running is really wearing on South. Over 38 plays in the first half. That's going to equate to about 80 on the game. Great job by the Coyotes controlling the top.
Monarch will have the football when the second half starts when we come back. It's 14-7 Coyotes over the Rebels, the 4A title game on Root Sports.
Thanks, Mark, with head coach Tony Lindsay of Denver South. Down 14-7 right now at the half. What were your overall thoughts on that first half?
I thought we moved the ball well. When we had the ball, we're just stepping on our own feet. We have all the penalties, they have none. And with that.
To deal with it, huh?
Monarch gets the football. There's that.
On Championship Saturday, young men believe, hope, and breathe glory. Under the lights, they feel untouchable, and the dream of a champion is knowing that anything is possible.
Getting ready to start the second half. Before we do, we go downstairs. Torrey Holt with Coach Lindsay of the Rebels.
Thanks, Mark, with head coach Tony Lindsay of Denver South. Down 14-7 right now at the half. What were your overall thoughts on that first half?
I thought we moved the ball well. When we had the ball, we're just stepping on our own feet. We have all the penalties, they have none. And with that being said, that's why the score is like it is. So we just have to stop the penalties in this play South High football.
What did you talk to the kids? Was it more of an upbeat, hey, let's just get back to our own game? Or was it kind of like, what are you guys doing right now?
It's kind of like I gave them the business. Yeah. Okay. That's how it was.
All right, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
All right. Usually pretty jovial Tony Lindsay right now. All business down 14-7.
I hear you, Torian. Matt, I heard his voice sounds like he's been screaming.
Yeah, and he has every right to go in there and you know, hurt some feelings if that's the case. But look, this is football. It's not feelings ball, okay? You need to go out there and execute if you expect to win. It's the coach's job to put your guys in the best position to do so. If he's got to choose some butt to get it done, then by all means,
take a bite.
Tony Lindsay expects to win. He was a star tailback at Thomas Jefferson in the 70s, walked on at Utah, and graduated from Utah with a couple of the degrees, had a tryout with the Broncos and the Denver Gold, eventually played in the CFL up in Toronto. Now the Argonauts, his team, just won the 100th Grey Cup last weekend.
And it's a football family. An absolute football family. A lot of his sons are on staff down there. The eldest Lindsay, if I'm correct, the quarterback at Oklahoma State, Tony Lindsay, was integral in beating my Colorado Buffalo squad when I was in college. So they definitely know what they're doing.
And Monarch's going to bring this one out and not get it past the 10, maybe to the 12.
Wow.
That was Bubernak bringing that one out. We take a look at Monarch's first half possessions. They threw once in the game, and it was intercepted by Cameron French.
Note to self, do not go after number two. And that's the only time that Coach Bravo has dialed up a pass during this game, and I wouldn't be surprised if it's the only time you see them put the ball in the air. Listen, besides the one punt and the fourth down stop that South got, Monarch has moved the ball at will, and they are controlling the time of possession in this football game, one of the keys to the game for Coach Phil Bravo.
And no surprise, Ethan Marks has been the man. I mean, when you look at the rushing yards that this team had on the year, almost 4,000. He basically has half of them coming into this game as they run it on first down, and they give it to Papp. Here's your time of possession for the first half. Monarch had the ball for over 14 minutes, South just under 10.
And you combine that with three turnovers by the Rebels, only one by the Coyotes, and then seven penalties by the Rebels and none for Monarch. You know, Coach Bravo was very diligent in preparing his football team for this game and not getting overhyped and overextending and getting penalties, whereas South is really shooting themselves in the foot.
There's Marks on second down, and he rolls it out.
The point of attack double teams here are blowing South off the football. Number 55, Sam Mabini, is a fine defensive player and an all-Colorado player, but he's standing straight up, and Monarch guard and tackle are double-teaming him 8 yards in the backfield. The young man needs to bend his knees and use his length and athletic ability to make some plays. If he stands up, he's going to be going for a ride routinely.
Pitch again, and another first down for Monarch. And we should say, you know, Monarch also plays with two tight ends, Andrew Dorsey and Connor Fitzgerald.
And Austin Braithwaite, number 70, is absolutely dominating at the point of attack right now. Sam Mabini, number 55, does not know what to do with number 70, Breswick. He is really getting underneath 55's pads and moving him off the line of scrimmage. Watch 55 when he lines up here, how tall he stands up out of his stance. He's got to get down, and it's the only way you're going to be able to let your linebackers run to the football over the double team.
Marks on second and five. Breaks it outside. And has a little bit of a seam. Gets hit out of bounds. But close to picking up another first down.
Shaquille Moore coming downhill right there and making a nice hit out of bounds. You see Mabini right there. Get his head in there. Get it, play with his hands and hold the point of attack. It allows the second level defenders to get downhill and finish on the ball carrier. Marks, number seven. Look at this contact.
Boom.
Ooh.
First third down conversion of the game for Monarch. They were 0 for 7. They moved the sticks up the middle. After a couple. And this is in the trenches. This is, you know, the epitome of 3 yards in a
cloud of dust.
Cloud of dust.
Amen to that. 9-on-7 football, it's pretty much bringing 9-on-7, which is inside run drill, if you don't know what we're talking about, where all you do is run power, ISO, trap. You know, the double wing option stuff that Monarch displays. Now, all you do is line up and play that type of football here. It translates well from the practice field to the game field, that's for sure.
On second and eight, Marks. Gets stuck for maybe a yard or two. Sean Johnson, one of the junior DBs in there. And you see Childs and Coleman.
And Denver South has rose to the occasion to play physical football. They have. They've definitely come out and stuck their face in there and started hitting at the same ferocity that Monarch is hitting with. They're just making mistakes, and Monarch isn't, and that's the difference in the ballgame right now.
Third down and six. First series of the third quarter of the 4A title game. From the 38 for Monarch. Sewell, who has a touchdown around the outside. First down, midfield. Still on his feet over the 40. Cuts it in. And down to the 29. A huge 32-yard run by Kid Sewell, who had a 25-yard TD run in the first half.
And the reach block on the left side is what I want you to see. The double team, the kick out, and the reach right there on the defensive end. Number 52. Oh, boy. Taylor Williams, excuse me. They do a great job of reaching Taylor Williams and then finishing. And look at the convoy in front. The quarterback, Cole Watson, is even out there on the convoy escorting his fine running back down the sideline for a huge gainer. Now they go into the power eye, full house backfield look.
and marks, wow, maybe a tough yard over the left side of that south line. So there's Ethan Marks. I told you, he's basically 65% of the offense of this team in the playoffs.
Monarch is doing whatever they want on offense right now. And what they want to do is pound the rock and smash you in the mouth and demoralize you as this game carries on. Denver South needs, somebody needs to rise up and make a play and get off the field. Start trying to strip after the ball because you're not going to get any interceptions in this ball game. Not anymore.
Just Marks again. Gets a few yards on second down. Let's go down to Torrey Holt. Torrey.
You know, the big key in this game has been turnovers. And Cole Watson, a guy who's very judicious with the football, had only one coming into today. That's because his coach says he's so smart. He's in AP Calculus, AP Language Arts, German 4. He's also in the National Honor Society. His coach says he's a strong Christian kid and a kid you want your daughter to date.
There's Ethan Marks, maybe 2 yards on third and seven, but this drive is now 11 plays long, and they've taken 4 minutes off the clock.
Number 52, Taylor Williams, making up for the mistake he had on the huge run down the sideline there, getting reached. Does a good job of shedding his blocker and making a huge play in the backfield there to bring up a fourth down. Looks like Monarch is going to try a field goal here.
Jamie Falloon on. And they're going to put it down at about the 31.
You better kick it out of the end zone, though, because Cameron French is standing back by the goal line. Remember, you can return a field goal attempt if it doesn't get there.
On fourth and six, the kick is up, and that kick is good.
Wow, what a kick by the young man. A three-point advantage in this ball game, if South does get back on the board, is huge.
So Falloon able to convert, and Monarch now 17-7, leading in this 4A title game. Championship Saturday is brought to you by Gatorade. The G-Series fuels. Championship Saturday is brought to you by Gatorade. The G-Series fuels Championship Saturday. Prime, perform, recover. Wells Fargo. When you're going for the win, Wells Fargo is with you. Together, we'll go far. AT&T Mobility. AT&T 4G LTE has you covered. Part of the nation's largest 4G network. The Denver Post, a proud sponsor of the Colorado Sports Hall of Fame and Colorado High School Activities Association. Monarch now up by 10. Jamie Falloon, a 41-yard field goal. 11 plays, 63 yards, 4:35 off the clock. That man converts. And Monarch, a successful drive to begin the second half after leading by a touchdown at halftime. Monarch, 245 yards on the ground. So Falloon will kick it off. And into the end zone it goes. Rebels will come out to their own 20. And it gives us a chance to take a tour of the Monarch campus. Over 1,500 students walk the halls of Monarch. They opened up in 1997, and the athletic programs have been successful. Almost every one of the 22 varsity sports has at least a league title. And oh yeah, that ACT score, the average ACT score of 23, that'll get it done. Be the change you wish to see is their motto. The Coyotes have the lead here. It's the 4A championship game. They last won 10 years ago. And Malik Tollerson and the Rebels offense trying to get things going here in the third. Pete Williams, that'll get it done. And he bounces off a Coyote. And how about 15 on first down?
And if I'm Tony Lindsay, the head coach for Denver South, I am leaning on my huge offensive line and my fantastic running game and going down the field and trying to score seven to get this thing close again. Pete Williams shows why he's one of the best in the state, an all-Colorado player, finishing at the second level and picking up a huge gain. Now, talking about the top, the time of possession. Monarch, 18 minutes and 52 seconds. South, 9 minutes and 49 seconds. Doubling up the Rebels.
There's Williams again. He just went over 100 yards, and he is going to be tackled for a loss. That said, he was part of your All-Colorado team.
Yes, he was one of the members of the All-Colorado backfield. Remember, you can go to milehighsports.com, check out the team, and 60strength.com. We'll have a full lineup of everybody that's on the All-Colorado team. Great job by Monarch of stretching that out. They do a great job of hitting the first level fullback at the point of attack and allowing the inside defenders to run to the football and make a tackle.
Tollerson going to throw. And has his receiver. It's knocked loose. Ball's on the ground. They're going to say incomplete.
He didn't have control of the ball before he brought it in.
That was Mosley.
So no fumble.
He got rocked.
But a great break on the ball there for Monarch and finishing through the receiver. Look at this. Boom. Ooh, big hit.
That's Jeff Clary, the senior. Favorite player, Champ Bailey.
Pretty one. That's a pretty good one to idolize right there.
Well, by the way, he's got a 3.8 and wants to be an engineer.
And Monarch is really showing, you know, the mental skills as well. They're not making the mistakes that South is making.
3rd and 11. Tollerson over the middle and over Chambers by about a foot. So it's going to be 4th and 11.
Monarch is doing a really good job of not playing with their eyes in the backfield. One of the things that gets a lot of secondaries beat in the state of Colorado is they're too eager to look at the quarterback or watch what's going on from a movement standpoint or motion standpoint, I should say. Monarch isn't doing any of that. They're playing disciplined football in the secondary, and it's allowing them to be in position to tip the ball, make big plays through contact or intercept the ball, as we've seen them do twice today.
Here's Logan Sewell ready to receive this punt from Suma. Hits it from about the 27. And Sue's got a fair catch it. And obviously let it bounce. And hit down about the 28.
He just had me confused.
We had a little bit of a depth perception up here.
No problem.
Monarch, so far so good. They're going back on 0 in the 4A title game.
Thank you.
It's time for extra credit from the Credit Union of Colorado. This time around, we highlight Denver South's A.J. Harris, big defensive lineman, four-point GPA, gave up basketball so he could concentrate on football and his honors classes. Credit Union of Colorado will donate $500 to the school district's General Scholarship Fund on behalf of the Extra Credit Athlete of the Week. Become a Credit Union of Colorado member. Find out how today at cuofco.org. And there's the big man on defense as the Rebels take over. And Sewell out again over the 30. 40. Big run his last time with the football. And a big one again down to the 41.
And this is what Monarch does. They chip away, keep swinging the hammer, hitting the rock, and eventually it breaks. And that's really the whole point of their offense is to just hit you. And when you've got your quarterback as a lead blocker, right. I mean, I can't say enough about Cole Watson, number 10. So unselfish, just to be the guy that gets everybody lined up, the game manager, doesn't need to throw the ball in order to be successful or to feel like he's part of the squad. He goes out there and does a great job. Anything that they need, Cole Watson is the guy that can get it to him.
Into Rebels territory and up the middle, and they're going to get about four on first down. Cole Watson actually dressed out for varsity as a freshman, didn't play, but was able to dress out. And the quarterback, big number 10, lives across the street from Monarch, went to Monarch's K-8 school. You know what he said? He could have went to Fairview or maybe Boulder, but he said, you know what Monarch does? They win.
That they do.
Fairview and Boulder, they're watching.
They are. That they are.
So second and five from the 36.
Cole Watson is a Boulder-grown tough guy, no doubt about it.
Sewell, who just went over 100 yards, picks his way forward over the left side. Maybe a couple of yards there, third and short coming up.
Shaquille Moore, number 8, the strong safety, coming in from the backside.
Feeling that one.
Running off the field right now, looks to be a stinger.
You know, I want to mention what Moore said about Tony Lindsay. He said his coach gives him hope to go to college.
And that's really what this is all about.
Right.
You're trying to give these young men the tools to succeed whichever next level they go to. You know, all these guys aren't going to be privileged enough or gifted enough to play at the Division I, Division II, NAIA. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where you go play. It doesn't matter if you play. It only matters if you have the skills to go out and be successful and knowing that hard work pays off. That's as a flag flies. First flag of the
first
day.
First flag right against Monarch.
First flag of the day from Monarch. Coach Bravo will probably use that against the squad at some point. You got to find something negative.
Jeff Bergstrom is going to give us the call.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard spot of the foul. Replay third down.
Hey, you can order your very own DVD copy of today's championship as well as other CHSAA championship events. All you have to do is go online to prepfilms.com. You see the web address at the bottom of your screen. What a day here in downtown Denver. Mark Stout, Matt McChesney, Torrey Holt. First of our two championship games. The 4A title has Monarch up 17-7 and a third and long. Some banging for about a yard. That left side. Let's see who gets up from the pile. Is that Marks again or was that Papp? I think it was the big guy, Papp, the junior.
Fourth and 9 here.
Yep, there's Marks.
And you're kind of in no man's land. You could go for this or you could punt it deep and try and flip field position.
Well, Monarch's 3 of 4 on fourth down. They get a field goal. I mean, if you can
get 9 yards running the football, then by all means, try it.
But they throw
time,
it.
Though, why not?
Marks will reset on the left side.
They're trying to draw him off here to make it a 4th and 5. 4, excuse me, once again. The math is off. What a shocker.
Happened in the first half. Timeout. Phil Bravo and his Coyotes. And with a timeout on the field, we'll take a timeout as well. Monarch will talk it over. They've got a 10-point lead in the 4A title game. Thank you.
3:34 to go in the third. There's number 34 of Monarch. Logan Kidd-Sewell came into the game with 477 total yards and 8 touchdowns. He's over 100 in this game with a TD.
And usually all you have to do is account for his marks and you can slow down Monarch. Not in this game. Kidd-Sewell is also having a huge afternoon. And now you have to be very wary of both wingbacks in this double T look. When Marks moves, he's probably getting the ball. When Kidd-Sewell moves, he's probably getting the ball. And here you go.
And he's thinking about throwing it. Lefty looking downfield, airs it out, picked off Cameron French. Now it's on the ground. And they're going to whistle it dead. So no interception. But on the 4th and 9, a little razzle-dazzle with the sophomore, who's averaging 15 yards a carry. He decides to throw it.
And it's almost the better thing that that Cameron French dropped the ball to give them more field position. See the halfback pass looking downfield. Denver South does a nice job.
Trying to get it to Marks.
They do a nice job of staying at their assignment.
So incomplete on that pass. Denver South, the Rebels back on O as they take over with 3:28 to go. Touchdown on the first drive. 7 plays, 82 yards. The numbers tell the story from that point on.
And after that first drive, the Coyote defense really settled down. And they had contained everything that South has wanted to do.
Williams, big run on first down.
They are still gashing them up front. Denver South is still showing the ability to run the ball effectively. They are just getting away from it too much, in my opinion. Stick with what works. At this point, with 3:23 left in the third quarter, you need to go down and get some points to make this game competitive here in the fourth. Try and get to 17-10 or 17-14.
See Williams' numbers, 114 yards after that 10-yard gain from midfield. Williams again, and he'll roll up the middle for about 5.
Driving forward. As you see Tank Tasco checking into the game, big number 9. Stick with what works. You know, the play-action game plan that Denver South came in to this game with, it didn't really work. He turned the ball over twice. And Monarch hasn't really bit on any of the fakes, as we do have a player down.
You see Williams, who came off. And one of the Coyotes is down. That might be Jake Stockerbrand, number 18, the sophomore.
6'3", 210-pounder. That's a large offensive or outside linebacker, excuse me, for Monarch. He's been playing a hell of a game today.
So Denver South trailing by 10. As we tell you about college football here on Root Sports. Today, Kansas at West Virginia at 5:30 after the 5A championship game. And then later tonight, Hawaii hosting South Alabama. That'll be at 10 o'clock, the best in college football right here on Root Sports.
Can't believe that's a Big 12 game now, Kansas and West Virginia.
I can't keep
still,
up with any
crazy to me.
Conference things. There's Tasco. Travante Tasco.
Tank Tasco.
Taking names.
And this is why we're so adamant about Denver South sticking to their guns. Go out there and do what you do. You're a power running team. Turn around and give the ball to your playmakers. Watch number 9 here finish right there. The wheels on the bus go round and round. That's all you can say about Tank Tasco. Only a sophomore. Big things in the future for number 9.
Here he is again from the 27. And still on his feet. Over the 15 and down to the 10.
What an absolute animal. And one of the reasons that he is the fullback on the All-Colorado team, as he checks out of the game and Super Pete checks back in. Now you've got the hammer and you've got the speed. The hammer goes out of the game after picking up 40 yards on 2 carries, essentially, and you bring in the speed guy, Pete Williams. Nice. Now, just watch the legs of Tank Tasco here. Contact, contact, contact. Doesn't matter. He's running through arm tackles, no doubt.
17 yards down to the 10. Williams trying to get around the right side, and Williams tackled at about the 8. So the Coyotes keep him out of the end zone as we come to under 2 to go in the third.
Great job by number 25, Zach Lindsay, of not blocking his defender in the back. Laying off the opportunity to hit somebody when he is showing you his numbers from the backside. Good job. Nice, heady play. Don't make a mistake you don't need to make. As the tank, number 9, Tank Tasco, checks back into the game.
Second and goal for Denver South. Haven't scored since their first possession of the game. And Malik Tollerson, their quarterback, snuck one in from a yard. Tasco. And Tasco bottled up at the five.
It's pretty, you can pretty much say that not one man is going to tackle number nine. You better rally to the football.
Well, we see that happen here. So there's Hart who comes in at the end and takes him down.
Great job by Hart hanging on for dear life there until the rest of his defensive mates out there could wrap up big number nine.
Third and goal from the four. Up the middle. And that is stopped. It's going to bring out a fourth and goal now.
Coach Lindsay obviously trying to trick him a little bit. Monarch not biting at all. Very, very disciplined defense. Now, what do you do here, Mark?
Do you
take the
3 points
or do you try and stick it in the end zone and make this a three-point game? Remember, it is a two-score game. If they don't decide to kick this, it is a very, very risky proposition as Coach Lindsay is calling for a timeout.
Trying to get his timeout. He gets it. So Tony Lindsay is going to think this over. The clock ran down to 34 seconds. You got a fourth and goal from the three. Let's show you the tank. You love Trevante Tasco.
I do. He is a hell of a fullback. And just, you know, you talked about Christian McCaffrey being a man animal. This is his compliment. You put this guy in front of anybody and he's going to scare the daylights out of you. Tank Tasco has been a one-man wrecking crew for South today. It just hasn't translated into points. Monarch is doing a good job of making tackles when they have to. Inside the 10-yard line, they've been pretty stout. Denver South is doing a good job of moving the football on the ground, but you've got to score points. Very interesting to see what they do here. Getting three makes it a one-score game. That being said, the way that Monarch is controlling the clock and the time of possession in this football game, you might only get one more possession if you're South.
Good point.
I mean, they ate half the time off the clock in the third quarter when they came back at half.
And that's why the Rebels will forego what would be a 20-yard field goal and try to knock it in. Travasco, Tank, can he get in? Haven't seen the signal yet. We're going to wait and see what the officials say.
Monarch stops him.
No touchdown for Denver South.
He looks to be laying over the goal line with the ball, so I'd love to see a replay of this. There definitely needs to be some discussion.
We're going to take a look at it.
Watch Tasco moving his feet, moving the pile. Where does he drop? That's a touchdown for Denver South. Touchdown for Denver South.
Wow.
Absolutely.
The Rebels coaching.
This is a missed call, and you know what? The officials need to come together because that is an absolute touchdown for Denver South, no doubt about it.
Boy, and the Rebels coaching staff all over the field. The flag has been thrown.
He is in the end zone before his knees touch. What a travesty by the refs not seeing this. That being said, you need to go, if they're not going to give you the touchdown, you need to go out and stop them. You've got them inside the one-inch yard line. Excuse me. Very aggravating to see the refs blow a call like this and cost a group of young men maybe an opportunity to win a state title.
The end of the play, sportsmanlike conduct. Defense.
I know we're supposed to stay ultimately positive here, but this is a travesty. And the refs, not only are you penalizing a team for pointing out something that's blatant to everyone in the stadium, including the Monarch fans who know that they just scored, but then you give them 15 yards because of the penalty. If I'm Denver South, this motivates me to go out there and really start hitting Monarch in the mouth. You need to get the ball back. Defense needs to rise up. That is a blatant missed call and unacceptable if you're the ref.
Travasco can't believe it as he comes off.
Time to rise up if you're the South defense. Monarch can definitely quiet him down.
A couple 3 yards for Sewell on first down as we near the end of the third quarter.
Now, and instead of focusing on what just happened, the South defense, the secondary, the linebacking core, the defensive line, the coaching staff, they need to calm down, get their feet back underneath them and focus on the task at hand. If they get the ball back here on a punt and they can stop Monarch on four downs, you have a chance to keep the field position going and go down and score another touchdown to get a field goal.
Rebels coaches, players, fans can't believe it as we head to the fourth quarter. And Monarch still with a 17-7 lead. It's the 4A title game here on Root Sports. Whether it's the joy of victory or the tears of defeat, this journey will turn young boys into men through competition. And memories made today with this team will last forever.
Who is going to win the 4A title? Denver South, upset after a touchdown that Trevante Tasco, number 9, thought he had and Tony Lindsay thought the Rebels had. Didn't happen. And then the flag, and so Monarch begins on O with a 10-point lead here in the fourth quarter. Ethan Marks. A couple of hard yards up the middle as we show you the stats from this 4A championship game between the DPS team and Monarch. And you see total yards are similar. The problem is turnovers, penalties, time of possession also.
And the time of possession is what we want to emphasize here. 22 minutes for Monarch, close to 14 minutes for South. That's a huge advantage, especially when you have three turnovers by the Rebels, and Monarch is not making many mistakes. I mean, the one penalty that they had in this ball game really cost them an opportunity to convert.
Second down, Marks. And he keeps his feet. His coach said he's a fitness fanatic. That's his 35th carry in the game. He's over 140 yards.
Obviously, the young man is in great shape, great football shape, as he can tote the rock 35 times. Good move by Coach Bravo here, sending out the punting team, flipping field position. The South took a long time getting down the field, ate a lot of clock off. Monarch, very, very heady play going out here and punting the football.
So Jeff Clary will kick it to Cameron French. On a 4th and 4, as we just get things underway here at Sports Authority Field at Mile High, and I think Monarch's going to have to burn a timeout.
Monarch.
So, there's Phil Bravo. Played his football at Azusa Pacific. This is punter Jeff Clary. Well, Phil Bravo had an interesting story out in California. He told us that coaching in California, he actually coached Mark Sanchez's brother Nick. And Mark was the ball boy.
And Coach Bravo has a long line of guys that he's coached with great success. Eric Bieniemy, we mentioned in the first half. the Jason Stout. Jason Stout, one of the fantastic running backs in the history of Colorado high school football, was at Centaurus when I was at Niwa, coincidentally, a guy that I played against in high school. So, listen, the list of coaches on his staff and guys that have accomplished great things, there's a reason Monarch is in the position they're in.
There's Coach Bravo. Yes. The Coyotes with a 10-point lead. 10-plus minutes to go in a football game. Do you kick it to French?
I would not kick it to French, no.
And that was the choice that was made by Monarch. Clary doesn't like his kick. That said, Denver South coming on offense when we come back. Fourth quarter of the 4A championship. See the score. Monarch up 10 here in the 4A state championship. The first of our two state championship games live here on Root Sports. Valor Christian and Cherokee Trail following this game. Kickoff scheduled for 2:30 for the 5A title. Valor trying to win their fourth straight title. They're first in 5A. Cherokee Trail, their first in 10 years in the existence of the school. 10 years to the day the school opened up.
That's going to be a very competitive, hard-hitting football game, no doubt.
Collison with a pump fake, and he is sacked. And we go down to Torrey Holt on the sidelines. Torrey.
Yeah, big sack there by the D-line, and their coach, Ted Kowalik, is one of three assistants that was on the staff when they went 14-0 and won the 0-2 state title. Since that time, Kowalik coached all four of his sons at Monarch and all sent all four of them to play Division I football. Chris went to CSU along with linebacker Michael, and Joey is now up at CSU. And also, Matt went to San Diego State.
All right, Torrey, look at Tasco. After we thought he had a touchdown on his next carry, he rumbles all the way up to the 23.
Tank Tasco busts loose. John Sanders, number 51, got the sack on that play before. Paying due to the young man's effort. Tasco running. I'm telling you, you better get a shoulder and some body on number 9. A
high
hand
easy.
And an arm is not going to work.
First down, Rebels from the 23. Why not? Tasco cuts it outside over the 20. Room 15. And bowls his way down to the 10. First and goal coming up. Denver South as Tank hobbles off.
Got his right leg twisted up there. It's one of the problems when you have to go low on a bigger back.
We'll take a seat on the bench. Let's watch what happened.
Bust into the open field here. And he tries to lower a shoulder on the defender. Defender goes low. Looks to be an ankle or a knee. We'll check it out.
Williams hits it over the right side of the line, down to the 5. Mark it at about the 6.
Petey Mitchell, number 29, the inside linebacker, does a good job of stepping in and making a nice tackle on Super Pete. Maybe looks to be a cramp in the calf.
Look at that thing.
I mean, you got tree trunks like that. I mean, wow. That's impressive, man.
Some work on the sideline. 5'8",
270. I mean, you got to be kidding me with this. It's like a Madden feature. It's like build a player on Madden. I want speed, power, can't tackle him, 5'8", 270.
That's impossible.
Like build a player.
Reverse, Chambers. Still on his feet, flag on the play. I think Matisse Moore might get caught on a hold or a problem on number 89. We'll see.
We'll check on the flag, but this is what Monarch's defense is all about, staying home and doing your job. They run the reverse, and the backside contain is sitting there waiting. And although he does miss the tackle, he still puts his teammates in a position to make the play. So hats off for doing your job.
Holding the offense, 10 yards from the end of the run, we play second down.
And on those long extended plays like we just saw, you get more of the holding penalties. Right, Monarch's got one penalty for 10 yards, South 9 for 78.
Well, good news for South. Trevante Tasco back after that cramp on the sidelines. Well, they are moved back to the 19. Tollerson rolls out. He's got Lindsay, and it's out of his grasp.
And this is what penalties do to you. They put you in uncomfortable situations. Situations where you're forced into doing things that you're not necessarily that great at. Having to throw the ball, you're moving the pocket, you're getting your quarterback who is an athlete in space, just right off the fingertips of Lindsay.
Watch it fall incomplete. In our super slow-mo. And he would have been able to turn that up as Denver South's going to take a timeout now.
And Denver South has done enough to be competitive and to be in this football game. Mistakes that they've made have hurt them. Missed calls by the officials have definitely hurt them. But also just missed opportunities. That's a missed opportunity. Something that cannot be ignored.
Saw Tony Lindsay, who was talking about how the DPS has South's back. As a Denver public school, hasn't won a title since back in 1989 when Thomas Jefferson, his alma mater, beat Montbello 34-32. All-City Stadium was packed to the gills in downtown. And there's the Denver South playoff history. So they were runners-up in 47. They won it in 1958 in a 7-6 win over Pueblo Central.
And remember, they were playing up a division last year in the 5A, lost to Bear Creek. This team is used to playing big football games. They're used to playing physical football games. Just need to go and finish in order to make this competitive in the fourth.
Tollison time, flushed out, throws. Moore makes the catch. And Matisse Moore on his feet won't go down. Down to the 10-yard line. So that's going to bring up fourth and goal.
Good job by big Matisse Moore of catching the ball with his hands, going back to the big tight end after he fumbled in the first quarter.
He's a big target.
See, again, setting up with the quarterback, letting him make some plays with his feet, does a good job getting the ball to his big tight end, the tight end trying to rumble, get some extra yards. It seems that everybody on South is pretty hard to tackle to me. But Monarch is doing a great job of rallying. They've always got four or five hats around the football, and that's the reason that they're winning this football game. South, I mean, you're kind of forced to go for it knowing that the Coyotes are going to run 5 to 6 minutes off the clock every time.
Thomas, got him. He's got him. He's got Lindsay. It was a quick snap at the line.
And they had what they wanted. They did a good job of moving the pocket, sneaking out the fullback into the flat, something that you see on Saturdays and Sundays. Nice play call. Tollison, the quarterback's just holding the ball for too long. He double pumps it and overthrows his fullback. Sometimes when he's open, that's the hardest throw to make.
Should he have run? Continue around the edge.
Hindsight is 20-20. Should he have run? I guess we'll never know.
Another lost opportunity for Denver South. They still trail by 10 in the 4A championship. Credit Union of Colorado, proud to support.
Today's 4A State Championship game on Root Sports is brought to you by the Ford Fiesta. With 40 miles per gallon, it's a pretty big deal. Ford Fiesta, go further. Credit Union of Colorado, proud to support Colorado communities. Brakes Plus, service you can trust at a price you can afford. And by CenturyLink, fast speed at a low monthly price. Visit CenturyLink.com. It's the 4A Championship game, Sports Authority Field at Mile High in downtown Denver. Monarch up 10, 7:39 to go in the game. Mark Stout, Matt McChesney, and Torrey Holt. And the Coyotes fans and the Rebels fans, and Monarch from their own five. And Ethan Marks gets a couple of yards. 3 minutes into this game, Denver South had a 7-0 lead. And then it was Monarch up 14-7 at the half. In the second half, Jamie Faluna of the Coyotes hit a 41-yard field goal. That's the only scoring we've had in the second half.
And that's really been the difference. That and the missed call on the touchdown by Tank Tasco. And then the missed opportunity down here at the goal line on Pueblo South's last offensive play that you saw. The missed opportunities are what is keeping South from having the lead in this game, no doubt. That being said, Monarch has done a great job of not beating themselves, something that South has done consistently all day.
Ethan Marks, first down run.
And if Cameron French isn't there to make that play, Ethan Marks is going 85 to the house, folks. Great job by French of being the last line of defense. But Monarch, you can see, Monarch is starting to really wear on the Denver South defense. Look at the backside pull, guard and tackle up. Lucky right there by French to make the tackle.
8 yards on that carry as we see Marks go down. That's 303 total yards from Monarch to South's 301. Marks, workhorse. French tackles him again. Same situation. He gets 11.
And it's almost like we hit rewind and then play, because that is the same exact play that they just hit Denver South with on the last play that they ran for another first down run. They're pulling the backside guard and tackle up into the hole, leading with a fullback. You've got three or four convoy members here escorting Marks to the second level. Once he gets there, there's only one man. Cameron French is doing an admirable job of making the play. Too bad it's 12 yards down the field.
Marks, 38 carries, 163 yards.
Monarch is a tough-nosed, really physical football team. They take pride in beating you up.
Papp, a yard, a tough one for number 15. He's knocked back.
And rather than looking at the plays they're running, look at the amount of time that's just trickling off the clock right now. We're going under 6 minutes.
Yeah.
The time of possession in this ball game is ridiculously favored for Monarch.
And each team with one timeout remaining.
The best way to stop the clock here, if you're South, is to get them off the field. You've got second and nine. You can't give up a 6 to 7 yard chunk of yardage here, because then you get the third and fourth down short yardage situations that Monarch has really flourished in this afternoon.
Just saw their linebacker Colin Hart come in with the play, and Marks gets hit. Taylor Williams was there, the senior, to hit him first, and he squirts through for about a yard. When Monarch is on the verge of having the football for about 10 minutes more in this game.
It's pretty much having the ball for an entire quarter more than your opponent. That's very effective football. It's what they wanted to do. Coach Bravo set out a plan to win this ball game, and they are executing it to a T. Limit mistakes, control the time of possession, and physically abuse your opponent.
Clock under five, Marks. And Marks is stopped for only about a yard on third down.
And now you have an opportunity to get off the field. Here comes the punt team from Monarch. Denver South is going to have another opportunity to go down and try and score some points. The problem is they need to do it at a very fast pace, because Monarch is going to get the ball back at least one more time.
Monarch is 1 of 12 on third down. And in many instances, they just go for it on fourth, but not on this occasion.
Yeah, it's smart to punt the ball.
Clary,
and
blocked.
It's blocked. Don't.
Oh, did the Rebels touch it? They whistle it dead. Boy, Denver South, it was a block. And it looks like the Rebels have the football.
And I'd love to see, I know we're going to see super slow-mo of this, to see if Denver South touched the ball. It was blocked.
That's Therefore, Sean Johnson. Yeah.
The call that's made is Peter. Get away from the football. If Denver South touched this,
Mabini
does a good job extending. Look at the reach on that young man, number one.
6'7".
Just a physical freak, a monster, number 55, does a good job of blocking the kick. After that, if the ball is touched down the field and Monarch recovered it, that's another blown call if it did happen. I guess we'll have to wait and see.
Tasco, right side, over the 40, 45, 50. And it finally steps out at the 44.
When Tank Tasco has the ball, the sideline is your best friend if you're a defender, period.
So that'll stop the clock with about four to go. They're talking about the time. It should go up from 3:56 to 4:08, I think I heard him say. Yeah.
So, okay. 4:08 it is, then.
He went out of bounds.
I would hope so.
Yeah. Tasco, 11 carries, 115 yards.
And everyone has a job to do, offensively, defensively, and even the officials have a job to do.
Here we go, South. Trying to get into the end zone quick. Pete Williams, left side. Stopped at the 42.
What a tackle made there by number 24.
It's Colin Hart.
The undisputed leader of that Monarch D, a guy that's all the calls go through. He gets everybody lined up. He's the quarterback of that defense, and he has been all over the field today making play after play. Very, very strong tackler for the Coyotes.
Loves Ray Lewis. Loves his fire and his leadership abilities. And policy. Put it on the ground. Now he's being chased, and he throws it across to Williams. Can they corral Williams? No, he gets around. Still on his feet. And tackled at the 25. What a play.
And busted plays like this, when the ball hits the ground, every one of the secondary players for Monarch and linebackers all look straight at the ball, and they lose the most dynamic playmaker on the field in Pete Williams. Tollison gets away, gives it up to Pete, and he's only got to beat one man in the flat. That's not very hard for Super Pete to do, and once he gets into the open field, he can make a play out of it. Good job of Monarch by rallying, by that being said.
On the 25, Moore makes the catch and steps out of the 13. There's Matisse Moore.
Just matriculating the ball down the field here. Only 3 minutes and 12 seconds left in this ball game. The two missed opportunities inside the 20 on the last two drives by South really hurt them, but they're not showing any quit, and that's admirable.
There's Malik Tollison, the senior, orchestrating this drive, trying to get into the end zone and get his team within three at the minimum. Tasco, 10. Five. Is he in?
Touchdown.
Travonte Tasco.
Now, Denver South just ran a traditional counter where they pulled the backside guard and tackle. Watch big number 78, Big Mike Williams, go out, grab his defender in space, and throw him to the ground in a very, very dominating fashion, opening up a hole for number 9, Tank Tasco, to finish at the pylon. Great blocking by his front. When Tank Tasco is not touched till 12 yards down the field, that's a problem if you're the Coyote D. 4 minute offense coming up here.
Suma, point after, up and good. So
it comes down to this.
The Rebels are within three.
It comes down to this. One first down. You
that's
get
it,
one
right?
First down if you're Monarch and you win the state title, period.
You got to come back to see how this one finishes. 3:04 to go. Coyotes up by three. They'll get the football. Watch Tasco run it in right in front of you.
South inches closer, down by three. Travante Tasco able to run it in around the right side. Big Mike Williams leading the way. And the Rebels now only trail 17-14. Look at the sophomore. Man, is he a big guy. And he had a touchdown on a fourth down situation that we thought was over the goal line, but it was called no touchdown, and Monarch took over.
And we're not thinking anything. The replay shows you that it's an obvious touchdown, and at the college level or the pro level, that is reversed, and Denver South has the lead right now 21-17. But you can't cry over spilled milk. Life goes on. You need to go out and execute on defense and get off the field to give yourself a shot to get in field goal range or score a touchdown to win the 4A state title. Monarch needs one first down to win the game.
Ball's on the ground.
Oh, boy, that pile's going to be fun.
Kick, yeah.
I'm telling you, folks, the bottom of these piles, if you have the ball, it's bad news for you. But there is a definite dogfight going on underneath that pile for the ball. Monarch comes up with it. Denver South is going to have an opportunity to go out and get the ball back for their offense. Monarch, get one first down, and you win the 4A state title.
Went off of Alexander's hands. And then the Coyotes able to come up with it after the dog pile. So 3:02 to go in the game. There's Cole Watson at his offense. And you see the big numbers. About 700 yards total offense in this football game. Monarch trying to win their second title and the first in a decade. And it'll go to Ethan Marks, and they do, and Marks rumbles up the middle for a nice gain on first down.
Close to 7 yards on first down. Denver South, you've got 3 yards. If you can't hold for 3 yards, Monarch is hoisting a trophy, folks. 5 yards, excuse me. A 5-yard pickup.
Second.
Once again, the math is off.
Five from the 37. You see the football here at Sports Authority Field at Mile High. What a day for teams to be playing in the Colorado State Championships, a day before the Broncos play. Why not? Marks again. And Marks pushes his way to within maybe a foot of that first down marker. Third down.
We're going to have a third and short here. Both teams only have one timeout. So if Monarch does pick this up, I expect Tony Lindsay to take his timeout immediately. That being said, you're going to be able to run four plays and eat under 2 minutes off the clock.
There's Phil Bravo. This is his specialty. He's been running this offense for 27 years. He said that Don Markham was his mentor in Southern California.
Well, it's definitely translating to the high school level out here.
Watson should have the first down on the sneak.
Interesting to see where they spot this. We could have a fourth down coming up.
The QB, who is 6'2", 210. Cole Watson started playing in the fourth grade for the Louisville Pirates. This might be our first measurement of the game.
What do you think, Mark? I'm saying it's short by 4 inches, and we're going to have a fourth down play. Just to add to the anticipation here. Nothing better than a fourth down play for a state title.
I know our photographer, Charlie Felix, is going to give us a look, and you'll see this chain get stretched out. And you'll know right away. It is apparently well short.
You're too much like this. Move it that way.
I expect Coach Bravo to go for it here. As he was all in earlier on fourth down, I expect him to be all in right here on this fourth down. This is the play of the game, folks. You pick up 8 inches. If you're Monarch, you win a state title. You stop Monarch if you're Denver South, and you have a chance to score and take it to overtime or win the state title yourself.
These two teams have a loss this season. Monarch lost to Wheat Ridge in week two when it was number two against number one. They lost at Wheat Ridge during their homecoming game. The Farmers won at 12-7, and the only loss for the Rebels was a loss to Broomfield. So, the story of this game,
grinded it out on the ground. Monarch, we knew they were going to use Ethan Marks, their junior. And Matt, have they used him?
Boy, have they. There's been a ton of opportunity for both Marks and for Kidd to go out and just exploit the physical nature that Monarch plays with.
And Kidd Sewell, the sophomore, chipping in with some big runs. He would go around the left side.
And Sewell is the perfect complement to Marks. Marks is going right. Sewell's going left. I mean, what are you supposed to do if you're Denver South? True, they don't throw the ball at all. You don't need to throw the ball when you can just line up and physically dominate the line of scrimmage and manhandle people at the point of attack. And it forces the linebackers and the secondary members to chase. 42 carries for 179. 42 totes in a high school game. That's insane. Hats off to the endurance of both these guys.
And Sewell has 122. And they'll both be back for Monarch after this year.
Fourth down.
Watson looks up again. And Monarch will use their final timeout. And Phil Bravo has done, what's this, the third time in the game?
Third time. And what they call this on Sundays at points is it could be called Kodak. And Kodak is when you walk out, you evaluate what the defense is doing and how they're lining up compared to your formation. You take a timeout, you get a picture, a Kodak, of what they're doing on defense, and that gives you an opportunity to better call a play on fourth down to win a state title. Very, very heady play calling and use of your timeouts by the head coach, Phil Bravo. Good job.
We got a chance to go down to the sidelines again to Torrey Holt. Torrey.
Yeah, number 28, Pete Williams. Just moments ago in most of this fourth quarter is giving a new meaning to T-Bowing down there on the sidelines right now. He's been praying. He's been staying by himself. He's been in silence, just waiting for an opportunity to get the ball back in his hands.
All right, Torrey, will it happen? Fourth and one, the situation. Minute 38 to go in the 4A title game. Monarch up three with the football. They need a yard. They give it to Marks. He's got the yard. And Marks erupts. The Coyotes fans erupt.
And that, my friends, is how it's done. Monarch comes out. They execute their game plan to a T all afternoon, not making mistakes, controlling the time of possession, and winning at the line of scrimmage. And in turn, unless there's unless Herm Edwards is on the field, yeah, and he's going to pick up the snap after they drop it, you know, I'm pretty sure that Monarch has taken a trophy back to Louisville. Congratulations to the Coyotes on a fantastic year.
Watson steps back, takes a knee as the clock will run.
Now, listen, we're not going to be the blind man up here and not talk about the biggest play in the game, which is the missed touchdown. Denver South should be sick. It's a definite mistake that they had nothing to do with. And sometimes football isn't fair, folks, and it can rely on the mishap of one that can cost so many a game. They still, if you could give two sets of rings here, you could do that. I mean, Denver South played very admirable. They had a great season. First time a DPS school has been in the championship game for a very, very long time. Coach Tony Lindsay won the Coach of the Year award for a reason. Denver South, I know they're distraught and heartbroken right now, and they should be. They did everything they needed to do to win this game. And it came down to one bad call that cost them. It's unfortunate, but still a very, very great football game to end the year. Monarch Coyotes are your 4A state title winners in the state of Colorado.
Mo-High football gets it done. Congrats to the Coyotes. They started the year as the preseason number one in 4A, and they're the last team standing at Sports Authority Field at Mile High. So Monarch ends up 13-1. Trevante Tasco and the Rebels lose just twice. And in heartbreaking fashion here in the 4A title game.
No doubt about it. And you know what? You're supposed to feel good when you win, and you're supposed to feel not so good when you lose. And the fact that you can look down on the field and see how distraught Denver South is lets you know that they truly care. And, you know, they were all in this season for their head coach. Monarch on the other side, they did everything they needed to do today to win. They executed their coach's game plan to a T. They ran the ball effectively. They limited turnovers. They only had one penalty in the ball game. and they had over 12 minutes more of time of possession, and that's really the biggest number. Hats off to the Coyotes winning their second state title in school history, and hats off to Denver South for just an incredible year. You know, besides one call, if one call goes Denver South way, if the ref makes one good call, then there's a different outcome down there. We can't deny the fact that that happened. I'm sorry.
Tony Lindsay and the Rebels will be back next year. And Monarch with Marks and Sewell, you know they'll be back next year as well. Monarch won this game despite going 1 of 13 on third down. They did convert 4 of their 6 fourth downs. And like you said, Matt, they were disciplined. They committed less penalties. There was one that actually kept them from getting a first down.
Yeah, their only penalty really, really bit them. South made a ton of mistakes in this ball game, but they still had enough to win the game. I'm going to stop talking at this point because I don't really know what to say at this point other than congratulations to Monarch.
Monarch in the semis beat Pueblo West at home, the number one team. And they won that game 14-6 with a 23-play drive in the fourth quarter that took nearly 11 of the 12 minutes off of the clock. And you see Jeff Clary and some of the Coyotes as they get it done in this game. And they're about to hoist that trophy. How about Ethan Marks? 43 carries for 186 yards and a TD.
And he's got to be your player of the game in this ball game. Hats off to Ethan Marks for all that he did. 43 carries alone is outstanding. I mean, that you can't deny the fact that he's probably the guy that's in the best shape on the field. The amount of yards he had and the fact that he had 43 totes and no fumbles. That's great ball security as well. Hats off to Marks.
That's 43 of the 68 plays Monarch ran. We're going to go down to the field. Drew Goodman of Root Sports is on now as we get ready for the trophy presentation here at Sports Authority Field at Mile High as we celebrate Monarch's win. Let's go down to Drew.
Once again, congratulations. What a 4A championship game. Marvelously played. Congratulations to the Monarch Coyotes and the Denver South Rebels. Well done, gentlemen. Let's join Assistant Commissioner Jen Roberts Ulig in making the presentation on behalf of the Colorado High School Activities Association to the 2012 runner-up in this year's 4A championship game. The Rebels of Denver South representing the DPS. And now we join Assistant Commissioner Harry Waterman from CHSAA. I think you're ready for this. The presentation of the 4A State Championship Trophy to Monarch High School, the Monarch Coyotes, and Coach Phil Bravo.
Here we go!
Here we go!
Yeah!
Let me get
Just, you know, you want me to?